college football bowl road trip brings us to Albuquerque, the first ever New Mexico Bowl, as the hometown Lobos, actually the visitors today, as they take on the San Jose State Spartans from the WAC. First ever New Mexico Bowl in a moment. Third and six. A rollout for Porter E. Throwing on the run. A first down to Marcus Smith down to the 30-yard line. The ninth play of the drive as Porter Reed drops the throw on third and 10 and has no chin. Grafalis downfield, wide open, Broussard. A blown coverage, and the game's first points couldn't be easier for the Spartans. 76 yards. DeAndre Wright from the goal line. Gets loose, makes a move to the outside. He's to midfield. Runs over the kicker and gets to the 40-yard line of the Spartans. Well, there's a momentum turnaround for the Lobos.
Porter E under center. Two wideouts to the wide side of the field.
Back to the ground in Ferguson. Lost the football. It's grabbed in the end zone, and loose with it is Demaja Jones. Up the right sideline with a caravan. Ferguson after him, and he's tripped up. What a turn of events.
Third down and 13. Motioning into the backfield is Giannis Davis. Four receivers.
They try to hitch one inside. It's tipped and almost intercepted.
And Jones has now gone over 800 yards for this season as Trafalis drops the throw. Picks up some protection. Rolls the pocket. He has Jones. Makes a move at the 10.
He'll walk into the end zone for a touchdown.
Rodney Ferguson back in the game.
He has the first down and more. Breaks a tackle. Ferguson loose. Makes a move in the secondary all the way down to the Spartans' 36-yard line.
Bird has made 12 of his last 13 over the last seven games. This one from 40 yards has plenty of leg, and it's good. A loss of eight on first down. Trafalis with the pitch. Davis
swapped under inside the 10. What a start to the second half for the Lobo defense.
You had missed the last two games of the season as Nelson was the starting quarterback. A flag flies as Ferguson breaks free.
And there'll probably be some extra yardage tacked on at the end of this run.
As did San Jose State, the first down of the third quarter for either team.
Now he wants six. What a catch made by James Jones into the end zone for a touchdown.
Playing about as good a football as anyone for San Jose State at the end of the season.
And now coming up to stuff the hole, Demaja Jones.
Looks as if the stalking job of Coach Tomey results in a bath. It took a long time to get him, and he does not seem at all happy.
You know what? There's 37 seconds to go.
He's
in the
not
game.
Feeling this. Here's the hug, Caper. Oh, he did not want that.
And those guys run away as fast as they can.
That's right.
Did you see that? Clock, of course, stopped with the first down. Nelson towards the end zone, looking for Smith. Jump ball. He's got it. Touchdown. And a bowl win. The first time that San Jose State has been in a bowl game since 1990. And Dick Tomey, in a two-year turnaround, leads the Spartans to a nine-win season. Their first bowl win since the last bowl that they were in, the California Raisin Bowl in 1990. So the win to San Jose State, again the final score of the inaugural New Mexico Bowl, 20-12. San Jose State wins it. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
They are the Nevada Wolfpack, the innovators of the pistol offense and one of the most dynamic attacks in the nation, led by WAC Freshman of the Year Colin Kaepernick. New Mexico, led by head coach Rocky Long, has always prided itself on the defense. Today, whose will win?
And the Lobos with a third down and six. Porter E well protected, complete over the middle. Marcus Smith will not be caught. Third play of the game, touchdown Lobos, 66 yards.
That bowl, the late unlamented Aviation Bowl.
Deep open over the middle again, Travis Brown. Touchdown, 39 yards.
In Lobo territory at the 39. They go back to Frager, and this is what's happened when they have tried to run and get to the corner against this New Mexico defense. 63 yards so far for Kaepernick, the WAC Freshman of the Year. And on the quarterback draw, no one is fooled. Nearly as often as they would have had he made his grades and been available.
Portery has had all day to throw. This one is picked off. Justin Jackson returns it near the 30.
Lippincott got six. Second down and four.
Great fake. Kaepernick still with it. First down to the 48.
Turn him into a linebacker.
So now to try from 53 yards out is John Sullivan, who kicks with a torn ACL, if you can believe that, in his plant foot.
How do you do that?
He leads the nation, 26 to 29. Longest is 46. This would better that by 7 yards. And it is good.
Amazing story. Just hit a 53-yarder, his best of the year by 7. This time from 45. Obviously, that's no problem. I guess the lesson for kickers is don't worry about impressing your coaches with tackling. It's not worth it. If you have to make a tackle, you're probably not going to make it, regardless of how hard you work on it. It has added to the amazing story of John Sullivan.
It's Rosenbloom belted at the 18.
Nation's leader in kicks and percentage.
Another one blocked. And this one is going to be returned into Lobo territory.
The defense has never given him a chance to display what he's been like all year.
Bruno in a foot race. And finally knocked it.
So from the 28-yard line, Baker makes the change direction and stays with the right corner inside the 5. First. And this time he is back on the mark. And the second New Mexico Bowl is over, and it goes to New Mexico, shutting out the Wolfpack for the first time since 1980. The 329-game streak is over. The 46-year bowl winless streak is over for the Lobos. And their celebration is already underway here in Albuquerque. We thank the New Mexico Board of Tourism for all their help.
Colorado State fans excited because their first-year head coach has the Rams back in a bowl game. Fresno State faithful have come to New Mexico to prove they still have that bulldog bark and bite. It's a clash of WAC versus the Mountain West in sunny Albuquerque. Welcome to the 2008 New Mexico Bowl, part of ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week. Today, two teams who experience ups and downs throughout the regular season are trying to finish with a sharp ascent here in New Mexico. Colorado State, Fresno State meet up at University Stadium here in Albuquerque. Anthony Harding starts at running back for the Bulldogs, and he gets the call, and a very good seam for Harding. And Anthony Harding breaks it all the way out to the 49-yard line. Harding back in, and Harding with another big run, breaking free. Here he is. Boy, did they make that look easy to Johnson. Third and one. Here he goes, breaking loose is Gartrell Johnson. This is Grant Stucker. And he's inside the 10 and trying to power his way into the end zone. Touchdown. Well, that penalty costly there. Grant Stater over the middle to Big Bear Pasco. Harding testing the middle and driving forward in for the score. Second and 11. Johnson. The blockers out in front. And Gartrell Johnson gets loose again on second and 10. Ferris with the little setup to Johnson and another first down. See, Jason Smith has had an outstanding year. This from 29 yards and the scoring continues. Anthony Harding, the lone back. Harding, look at this. Another first down from Harding in NCAA for another year of eligibility. Here's the forward pass to Johnson, and Gartrell Johnson is breaking loose from 22. And that is up and good. Lanye Miller finds an opening, and here goes Lanye Miller. He was bottled up, and
rush for a 69-yard touchdown.
Ferris taking his time, taking a shot at the end zone with a big tight end. Touchdown! Whoa. Back is Harding. Right up the middle and right over the goal line. Touchdown, Fresno State. Back to the starting quarterback. Johnson lowering his shoulders and getting free. How about that from Gartrell Johnson? Johnson in for the score. An ACL to get back in the mix. Ferris now cranking it up on third and six. Greer holds it in. He gets loose to the end zone. The Rams take the lead. Humble, modest man. But this is it. And here goes Gartrell Johnson on a day where he has been shining bright. Johnson all the way in. Jura Tutu now in motion, coming back to that near side. Grant Stater goes over the middle and gets it complete for the score to Ryan Skidmore. And our final score of the third ever New Mexico Bowl, Colorado State 40, Fresno State 35.
The postseason is here. We welcome you to the 2009 New Mexico Bowl, all part of ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week. University Stadium here in Albuquerque, the site, gorgeous Saturday afternoon for football as the Bulldogs of Fresno State get set to take on the Cowboys of Wyoming. And just a few moments ago, the teams on the field for the warm-ups, a signal that this may not be a cordial affair. A team from the Mountain West, a team from the WAC, revved up early to meet this afternoon here in Albuquerque just to become bowl eligible and earn a trip here to the New Mexico Bowl. Third and eight. Curtis Samuels can run it. He's got a lot of ground, too. First down and more. First and 10. They place it down at the 40. They're going to run it this way, trying to get around the edge and get a block. One of three men back deep for Fresno State. Almost got there. And this could be a good one. Down to inside the five and close to the one. From the 32 for Wyoming. Curtis Samuels hands it off to Alexander, who breaks through. Clear running. Trying to get to the end zone. He's going to make it. Touchdown, Wyoming. Play action. Over. With time. Throws. Man wide open. Inside Wyoming territory. And here it's fourth and three. They're going to go for it. Matthews breaking through. Still up inside the 10.
And you can see how Matthews steps through tackle.
First and goal from the four. Matthews into the air, into the end zone. Touchdown. In the Mountain West, they ended up right in the middle of the pack. Fifth. Curtis Samuels. Speed to the outside. Using it and picking up another first down.
And then they adjust back to what they were doing.
Going to run it this way on third and 10. Got some room across the 40 and out across the 40.
New Year's Day.
And he does not lose bowl games. 5-0. Reno as a coordinator. Curtis Samuels throws off balance. Jump ball in the end zone. Let's see who came down with it. Touchdown, Wyoming. Matthews stepping up. Colburn looking to the end zone over the middle. It's caught. Did he keep his feet in? Did he hold on? We'll wait for the signal. It is a touchdown. But it might be. They run the reverse. West going to throw it. Got a man wide open. That's two of them, as a matter of fact. Touchdown.
Number is long this year from 43.
That one blocked earlier in the game. This one's good. Matthews the call. Straight ahead. Still up. Still up. Far sideline. Curtis Samuels. Looking to run it, can't. Dropped behind the line of scrimmage back at the 14-yard line.
He took Spanish at UCLA, didn't he?
Muy caliente, I guess, would have been appropriate.
30-15 over the middle. Tipped up, intercepted. Fresno State has it. Bringing it back. Inside the five, stepped out of bounds at about the 5-yard line. Second and goal. Call it the 5-yard line. Wildcat, Matthews directly to him. Barrels his way down to the goal line. waiting for a signal, and there it is. Touchdown.
He was all gacked up.
Austin Curtis Samuels hands it off. They're going to run it this way. Alexander breaks through, and
he like his arm strength.
Quick throw as he's hit. Leonard to the end zone. Touchdown. They're trying to make it a three-point game. Looking, throwing, got his man. As Pat Hill watches, down, up, and good. First and goal from the one. You think number 21 might get a call here? Stop, though, short of the goal line. Second and goal. Going to try it again. Fights close.
I don't think he got it.
He didn't get it. No signal. And so they offset Camp and Matthews now on third and goal. Colburn. He does sneak it. Fights his way. Stopped initially. And again, no signal. Here we go. Fourth and goal. Colburn. Going to hand it off to Matthews. High into the air. Stopped right there at the goal line. And what a stop defensively for Wyoming. Are you kidding me? From 40 yards, the man who wasn't recruited by anybody, a walk-on. And he pulled it. No good. And we're still tied at 28. And it's back to the stands for the Wyoming fans, just finding your seat again.
Experience-wise, doesn't play like it, though.
Nobody with him in the backfield. Steps up. Gets out again. Lofts it up for Leonard, who makes the catch. Did he stay in? He did.
The pressure.
So it comes down to this. Fourth down. Colburn flushed out of the pocket. Looking. Running. Still looking. Still up and now goes down. Throws it out sideways, and that's it. What a finish here in the New Mexico Bowl. 35-28, and now they can rush the field. They did it once already, had to go back to their seats, but in double overtime, Wyoming pulls off the upset over Fresno State. 35-28, your final.
Welcome to Albuquerque in the first of 33 bowl games over the next 24 days on our ESPN family of networks. It's the 2010 New Mexico Bowl, part of ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week. It's BYU taking on UTEP. Bob Shoes alongside Brian Greasy. Jen Brown with us here as well here in Albuquerque. Also about three rolls of tape, and he opens with five wide receivers and swings one to McClure. McClure maintains his footing. And he's here today watching his son finally playing a bowl game. And on second down and four, Vitito. He does not have the scrambling ability.
And only 74 yards on the ground.
Ian Campbell kicks it away to J.D. Falslove. Falslove all the way back to his own 20-yard line. Made the first man miss. Made the next two miss. Falslove in the open field. Into plus territory. Finally. J.J. DeLuigi blown up in the backfield. Nowhere to go. And off Korea, right up the middle, and BYU's got a touchdown. Making the catch at the five, reaching for the goal line, in for the touchdown, Luke Ashworth. Our ESPN family of networks. McClure on the bounce, picks it up at the five. Runs into his own man, and then finds some room. Marlon McClure down the sideline. And right now he's on the sideline. Vitito, though, with great field position. The blitz comes from the blind side, and down goes Trevor Vitito. Field, Warren from 52 yards away. He's got the distance, and he's got three. And bringing it out of the end zone, Cody Hoffman from about 6 yards deep. Down the sideline he goes. He broke his brother Matt's record from 38 yards away. He tacks on three more for the Cougars. Play action for Jake Heaves. He wants the end zone for Hoffman. He's got it. Should never jump off sides defensively. He's the guy right over the ball. DeLuigi finds a crease. J.J. DeLuigi down the sideline. Jones looking for touchdown pass number three, and he's got it to Cody. Four-man rush on first down. Vinatel looks for a big play for the first time for UTEP, and he's got it to Chris Adams. Touchdown. Heaps, high throw, and it's intercepted. Picked off, Trayvon Nixon down the sideline. Nixon picks up a block at midfield. Turns the corner. UTEP tries to bring a blitz on third down. There's the tight end. Devin Mojito reaches for the goal. Now it's a toss to DiLuigi. And he gets to the pylon.
A lot of injuries on this offense.
Vinatieri to the sideline delivers a strike
to four.
First and 15. Vinatieri lobs one left side end zone. Chris Adams, touchdown. BYU brings four on second and 10. Vinatieri intercepted. He threw it right into the arms of Adam Rich. Of Vinatieri today. Heaps down the sideline looking for the end zone. Cody Hoffman battles for the football. He's got another. Quezada down to the five towards the goal line. He's in. Vinatieri, all the time in the world, goes deep for Adams again. He's got it. Vinatieri fires one. It's tipped and intercepted. Another pick for Rich.
You may want to go get a jacket. Find a jacket somewhere.
Oh,
they got him.
Let's see. He dodges the bucket and then gives him the fist pump. Yes. That's right. That's how good I am. And then all of a sudden they found a couple of the squeegee bottles. Clark to take one more knee. And that will officially end the 2010 New Mexico Bowl.
The 2011 College Football Bowl season is ready to get underway today from Albuquerque, New Mexico. It's the 8-4 Temple Owls out of the MAC facing the Wyoming Cowboys from the Mountain West, also 8-4. From University Stadium in Albuquerque, it's the Gildan New Mexico Bowl. Wyoming in brown and white. Temple in white. Temple will receive, and the bowl season is underway. It's a squib kick from the Cowboys, and it's going to work out well for them. Picked up at the 10-yard line by Matt Brown, and he is dumped at the 9. Marty English, the defensive coordinator, says it's going to be 8 and 9 in the box on most plays. Coyer on third down, rolling out. He's going to run, and he's got enough for a first down. Four seniors and a junior up there. Third down and 2. Pierce. And he is going to be stopped short of the first down. First down, Temple. Coyer, play fake. Man, play down to the 10-yard line. Longest pass play of the year for Coyer. Now Pierce again. And he's down to about the yard and a half line, a gain of 9. Coyer away from center, gives to Pierce, touchdown, Owls. Same spot on the field, Temple converted theirs. Smith under center, he'll take it himself, and it's a first down. He is a leader. Smith sprinting out to Alvester Alexander, and he's got some room. Check that, that's Brandon Miller. And speaking of New Mexico, we're going to be talking with Bob Davey, former colleague, now the head coach at New Mexico, just in moments. Joe Jones on the end around. Big play for Temple inside the 40. First down and 10. Coyer, and dump for a loss.
To carry defenders through the hole, that's the thing that impresses NFL scouts the most about Pierce.
And he'll get it again. Touchdown, Pierce. His second touchdown today. Second down and 14 as they back it up to the 48-yard line of Wyoming. Smith, pocket collapses, steps up, throws, intercepted. Picked off at the 35 by Kier Griffin. Temple 3 of 4 today on third down conversion attempts. Bernard Pierce in the backfield gets it again. Hit, gets away from a tackle and bounces to the outside. Down to the 15-yard line. Brown, touchdown. Wyoming is going to go for it here on fourth down. It's fourth and a long 2. Three receivers to the right. Smith will run, and he's got away. First down and more. Spins inside the 30-yard line. So Wyoming again going for it on fourth down. They're 2 for 2 so far. Throwing this time. Smith to the end zone. Caught. Touchdown.
Since throwing that pick, Smith is perfect. Another squib kick. This is Joe Jones on the return.
And he'll get to the 30-yard line. Stays on his feet. 35 and close to the 40. He's down at the 39. Great return for Jones.
Get some momentum going.
Smith in trouble, and he's going to be dumped. A sack at midfield.
This is the opening series of the half for Wyoming. It's been inconsistent, to say the least.
Roof ran. And again, nowhere to go, and this is going to be a loss. 34-yard field goal attempt for Brandon McManus. McManus has done a little bit of everything for Temple. First down and 20. After the penalty. It'll be Coyer, and he's going to be met immediately. Bazunes is there at the point of attack. This is going to be a loss of 2. That's the rumor. This is a 37-yard field goal attempt for McManus.
Look to join the Big East, and potentially Louisville may talk about joining the Big 12, so there's a lot that still needs to be decided.
Smith hit as he throws. The throw is short, and it's intercepted.
He's hit from 34 and 37. This also from 34. He's been perfect today. And we're coming up on 2 minutes.
Coach is going to wish he had that jacket on.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that's cold now, isn't it?
Steve Adazio.
Cody Sutton, big run here for Wyoming. Continuing to play hard, and he'll bang his way to the 30-yard line.
That's next on ESPN.
There is Smith in all kinds of trouble back there, dancing around. Fourth down, Wyoming. Likely the final play of this game. Smith will throw it out to the flat, and this is going to be a touchdown, so the timeouts pay off. Cody Sutton goes in from 14 yards out. Everything has to be perfect. And here is Smith. He will take it in for the 2-point conversion. Steve Adazio certainly hopes so. Once again, from Albuquerque, our final score from University Stadium, 37-15.
Welcome to Albuquerque, and welcome to the Gildan New Mexico Bowl as we begin the bowl season here in the high desert. Two of the more high-powered offenses in college football. Set to kick things off as Nevada takes on Arizona.
Well, we begin the bowl season today. A moment ago, Nevada taking the field. It's the Wolfpack and the Wildcats in the Gildan New Mexico Bowl. And we are just about set for game time here in Albuquerque. Jefferson right up the middle. He'll walk in for a touchdown. Another pass in the flat, this time to the near side. Wimberly breaks a tackle. And he has a first down and then some. Second down and 10. The option to the far side. Aaron Bradley, the wide receiver, acting as the option back, picks up 11. That's another first down for Nevada. Jefferson shut down. He didn't get there, might have lost a couple of yards. First and 7 after the penalty. And now it'll be first and 8. Fajardo on a rollout, looking end zone for Sudfeld, and he's got him for the touchdown. Jared Baker from the goal line. Lost the football. And Nevada might have it. And they do. A play action fake for Fajardo. He'll do exactly that. Looking for Sudfeld again. Touchdown. Up fourth down and 3. Arizona trying to keep the drive alive. Scott will try and run for it. And he backs his way with a reach of the football to the 22-yard line for a first down.
Grayson from the poor decision on the third down says, I'm going to get it on this one.
And now Kadeem Carey up the middle for the touchdown. Fajardo straight back to throw under some pressure. Using his legs to get to the edge, and he'll try and run for it. He'll get it easily. And then some, all the way to midfield. Play action for Fajardo. He wants to go up top, looking for Richie Turner, and that's intercepted. Momentum.
momentum took Shaquille Richardson into the end zone, and he'll bring it back out. And he trips at about the 25-yard line and falls out to the 30. Hood stayed on the sideline, and here's the offense getting work done for Arizona again. Dan Buckner stumbling for a catch. Dean Carey, he's up the middle. Big gainer for Carey. Down to about the 12 before he's brought down. Scott slants one at the goal line, reaching for the end zone. Dave Richards lost the football.
Gap.
This time the quarterback tries it himself with some power, and Matt Scott there got is. There for a touchdown.
Fajardo beat that play.
Now it's Jefferson inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Lost the football. It came out late, and Arizona's got it.
Arizona.
And he'll go right up the middle again. Breaking tacklers. That's a first down to the 37 of Nevada. Four-man rush. Scott, double move down the sideline. Lofts it right along the chalk. Richards has it at the 16-yard line.
Pick up. These guys got to get into the game, and they've done that now.
Quarterback keeper for Scott. He's got a lane. Oof. Right at the goal line. Touchdown.
Patience to stick around. The perseverance has paid off.
And there's some perseverance. A touchdown run for Carey.
Oh, the injury bug.
A fake and Fajardo out on the edge into plus territory before he's finally brought down. The seas part for Jefferson, and Nevada's back on top.
Yield.
Play action fake for Scott. Up the seam. And that's pulled in by Austin Hill. Terrific catch. Nadine Carey makes a man miss in the backfield. He's at the 20-yard line. All the way down inside the 10 before he's brought down. Carey again, another cutback. Jitterbugs to the 5. Into the end zone for another touchdown.
Inside kick, we don't get it. You know, they're probably going to score anyway.
Fajardo on 2nd and 10. Has a first down. They bring a blitz. Quarterback draw for Fajardo. And he's about 2 yards shy of the first down. Maybe a yard shy. Fajardo follows his blockers and picks up the first down on 4th and 1.5 yards.
They take a shot.
They might on a rollout. Fajardo up the seam. Bobbled but held onto by Joseph Huber. And he's got that one. The Wolfpack 4-4 in their first year in the Mountain West Conference, but back in a bowl game. Bubble screen to the near side to Richie Turner. Makes a man miss. Turner down the sideline.
And now you see it again with 44 coming across there.
Well, there's a double move and a room service touchdown. Richie Turner. Instead, it's Scott to throw. Wide open up the sideline. Leaping catch made by Austin Hill. Scott directing traffic downfield, throws across his body, and it's intercepted. Never a good idea. At the 15-yard line, Bryson Keaton. Another big run for Nick Hill. Down the sideline.
Get your offensive lineman in better position to block.
Little option concept on the fake dive, and instead it's Dan Pettinato. They're not struggling with him in there. Fajardo on the fake. Boy, did he get hit hard, and he might be woozy, and a flag comes out. 15th play of the drive. And it's Fajardo on the keeper for the touchdown. Scott fakes one way, goes the other, high throw to the sideline, and that is another terrific catch by Austin Hill. 3rd down and 10. Matt Scott looking for the home run ball for Richards. And he hauls it in. Check that hill. Touchdown. Carey slowed up and pays the price. Lost a yard. Here comes a blitz. It's picked up. He'll loft it right up the middle of the field, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Duke Williams. He's up the sideline. Tiptoes along the sideline out to the 40-yard line. A little pooch punt that lands inside the 10 and is kept out of the end zone. Great coverage on the kick by Tenpenny, downed at the 5 by Jonathan McNeil. And they'll play it conservatively, and it might be good enough. Hale on 3rd and 14.
15, right at the first down stripe. And they will snap the ball and go for it. Fajardo inside the 12, and that looks to be good enough for a first down, and it is. So they bypassed the field goal and try and end the game here. But any hope that Arizona had, you would think, was dependent upon a stop there. And this one is good. So Matt Scott needs some chunk plays. He'll come underneath, and that is not going to get the job done. And the ball comes out. It's scooped up by Wharton. To the outside again. Terrence Miller. Scott again, same play. Same result.
There it is.
Launching it down the sideline to Scott. With a flag out of play. And Scott tries to force one into a tight window and does. Here comes a blitz. Scott looking end zone. Underthrows his intended receiver again. It's Miller. But another flag out in the end zone. And they get it. Austin Hill. Mano's point after is good. And now it's a 6-point game with 42 seconds to go. So it all now comes down to this. If Arizona can recover the onside kick, they would recover it at a spot on the field where as quickly as they just moved offensively down the field,
yep, they're right there.
You'd have to at least think they would get in position and maybe have an opportunity to go to the end zone. All Nevada has to do is recover the onside kick, and they will be nothing more than one knee away from winning the Gildan New Mexico Bowl. So here's the onside kick. And it's loose. A scramble for it. Wildcats think they have it. It bounced off Duke Williams, and who has it at the bottom of the pile? Arizona has the ball at midfield. In a game like this, whoever would have thought it would have come down to one of the two teams needing a defensive stop. High throw up the seam, and Wharton's got it. Down to the 23-yard line. It looks like they will run a play. To the sideline, it's the Austin Hill out of bounds inside the 5. 22 seconds to go.
How about the same play they ran the touchdown previously, though?
A slant into the end zone. It's caught for the touchdown. Terrence Miller. And now to break the tie and make it 49-48. Bonanno. And he's got it. Fajardo has to look downfield, throws a high one at the seam, and it's intercepted, and that'll end the game. Marquise Flowers gets the pick. And what a way for the fifth-year senior Matt Scott to end his one and only season as the primary starter and quarterback for the Wildcats, with a win in the Gildan New Mexico Bowl and a 2-touchdown comeback in the final 90 seconds. And what a way for us to start the bowl season. Hopefully the next 32 are as good as this one.
Sweet passes. Mason very involved in their passing game.
Second down and 8. Halliday with time got rid of it quickly, and he's intercepted at the 31-yard line by Max Morgan. It's a very balanced offense, and the pass complete. Forward progress, and it's ripped. Ripped clean. Nolan Washington. And they take it right back on the next play. This time he gets rid of it quickly, complete to West. Stops up. Great spin move. And West with a first down for the Cougars at the 25. Third and long. Plenty of time. Into the end zone. Touchdown. Craycraft. A little heat. And backside pressure. He threw it away. Makes it a third and long now. 12 to go. More heat up front. That might be grounding. Not sure he was outside that tackle box. Cooper and Viau applying the heat.
What about a mile high altitude? They blocked it. They came after it out of bounds. And the Cougars knife through that front. Looks to the wide side. Touchdown. And second in the nation in touchdowns.
Got him.
They're going to take a shot up top. Wide open. A busted coverage. And you're talking about six Ram style.
Let's see how big a chunk he wants to take here on third down.
They heat him up and get to the quarterback Halliday for the sack.
If you're playing sports, you can't be afraid of your feelings being hurt.
All day for Halliday. Touchdown. West with a catch. Third and one. Play action. Wide open. Caught. Cartwright. All the way down near the 10-yard line. This one from 25 yards out. And he hooks it inside that upright. Going for it on fourth down. Bibbs gets it and then some. And what a collision. That's what we've been waiting for all day. They're going to fake it. They go for it again. And close to the first down. Looks like they got it. First and 10, Grayson going to throw it, and he's picked off into coverage. And it's Buchanan. A little pressure coming from Colorado State. They picked it up, and it's a touchdown. Maley with the catch.
Beautiful.
It led to an otherwise successful finish. Looking for success here, won't find it. Sacked back at the 33-yard line. Wide open, Craycraft got his feet down. It's going to be complete at the 7-yard line.
Just one of the little adjustments that Wazoo has made today.
Halliday. Waiting, touchdown!
But good patience, you can't get it all back with one throw.
Slings it complete to Gilmore again on 2nd and 10. Underneath, that pass complete to Higgins. That's their playmaker. Break the huddle quickly. They overload the left side. Bibbs, touchdown, no doubt on that run. 2nd and 10. And a sack back at the 10-yard line. Jared Roberts from 30 yards out. And it's a 12-point game. Halliday over the middle completes it this time for the first down to Craycraft. 15-19 on the season and knocks this one through as well. Bibbs in the backfield. You'd imagine it'd be a little frustrating for Bibbs today. Nice run. Breaks one over the right side. Does he have enough to take off? Bibbs kicks it into another gear. He's got it. Touchdown Rams. Halliday completes it to Craycraft. And safe to say with that catch, they've made up, right, Brock? 2nd and 4. Halliday sacked back at the 33-yard line. The 11 for the first down. Backside pressure, and they got him again. And a fumble. The ball came loose, but they're going to say it was down first. Looking at 3rd and 5. Grayson takes off, got the first down at the 33-yard line. Garrett Grayson doing it with his legs. 1st and 10. Coach McElwain in his second year building it from the ground up. Should be a signature win for them early in his tenure. The pass complete to the edge. Vaden getting a lot of work, and he fumbled it. The Cougars recover it. 1st down and 10. Colorado State seizing some of the momentum here. Grayson on the run, fires complete, catch and then some.
Well, that's automatic between you and receiver, hitting the back shoulder and moving the sticks.
Halliday's completion percentage up big time this year, but sacked on that play at midfield. Although nothing about Mike Leach says conservative. Halliday, wide open, touchdown! Isaiah Myers.
Kids right now verbally committed. And for Colorado State, well, you are really having to recruit. You don't get to select as they did at Alabama.
Pass complete to Hansley.
Well, most of the five-star guys don't have too many fatal flaws.
That's a good point. That pass complete to Lovett. And Lovett with another Ram first down. Grayson pulls the trigger complete to his tight end, Gilmore.
And, well, he's going to continue to be aggressive plenty of time.
Grayson wide open. Touchdown, Colorado State. Colorado State out of timeouts. Fumble. Colorado State recovers it. Halliday got ripped. And he coughed it up. Wow.
I have a little opinion. Don't hate to do it.
After further review, the runner was down prior to losing the ball. Therefore, it was second 10.
Time. That is unbelievable.
That they would snap it that quickly and they get stoned. And defend another fumble. Back-to-back fumbles. And this one recovered by Colorado State. Wow. At the 33-yard line. First and 10 for the Rams. No timeouts remaining. Grayson fires. And it's caught by Vaden.
End of game mechanics. So critical and can be so costly, especially in these bowl games.
Grayson, Vaden was running before he made the catch that time. They run it. Bibbs right up the middle. Down to the 17-yard line. 1:19 to go. Grayson fires, incomplete at the 10. Vaden split to the bottom of your screen. He's been the go-to guy in the second half. They go his way. He's got some real estate ahead of him. And Vaden steps out of bounds at about the 11-yard line with 1:09 to go. It is with Bibbs. Made a nice move, makes it down to the 2-yard line. First and goal. Bibbs stopped short. Bibbs again. Fumbled it, but he was in. Touchdown. Hansley and Vaden split to the bottom of your screen. They hand it off. Alexander, did he get there? No signal. He didn't make it. He extended that arm, tried to hit the pylon, and came up short. One more look.
Sure did. Ooh, and I think you get away with maybe a little bit of hold on the edge.
Ooh,
and Steve, your job's not done yet.
Great look here. Oh, geez.
Ruling on the field is that the try was short of the goal line. The previous play is under further review.
Here's the ruling.
After further review, the runner did penetrate the goal line with the ball. Therefore, the try is good.
And we're tied at 45.
Is there a better way to kick off bowl season?
I would say no.
We're 4 hours in. We may be here another hour. Gives you an opportunity to still get in the field goal range.
Yeah, Andrew Fernie has a career long of 60 yards. On the return, this is Caldwell. And he had it come loose. Another fumble! Washington State literally fumbling this game away. 27 seconds to go. And they play it conservatively. Bibbs protecting that football with two hands. Stomped up right near the line of scrimmage. 7 seconds to go. And they spike it. And stop the clock with 4 seconds to go. And in comes Jared Roberts to cap what would be a miraculous turnaround and a signature win for Colorado State in this, the second year of Jim McElwain's tenure. He's 20 of 23 on the season, Jared Roberts. An unlikely, implausible, like almost impossible ending. Trying to put a period on it here. Roberts from 41. Got it! It's over! And the Rams run roughshod in the dying moments to steal it.
and they get their eighth win of the season in what will be one of the most memorable wins maybe in all of their bowl history.
Welcome to college football bowl season.
34 bowl games to go, folks. There's our final score.
A nice day here at Albuquerque for the ninth annual Gildan New Mexico Bowl. This has been a game the last few years. It's come down to the last couple of minutes. Jake Thompson to kick it away with Golden back deep. Golden had a 98-yard kickoff return for touchdown November 1st against Southern Miss, and a 92-yard kickoff return for touchdown a week later at Western Kentucky. And this Gildan New Mexico Bowl is underway. It bounces past Golden and into the end zone and will be down there. Handed off to Jones, but he is met in the backfield by Travis Seafelt, number 70. Second down at 7. He keeps it. Myers can run. And he has the first down. Uses a stiff arm.
Aaron Jones is a linebacker that can run.
Myers to throw. Now flushed out and brought down. In motion, Golden. Showers looking to throw, but now he's pressured. Showers being chased. He throws it going deep. He's got a man out there. Caught at the 20 by Ian Hamilton.
Good job of the Utah State defense holding up and forcing UTEP to settle for three.
32-yard attempt off the right hash and sneaks it inside that right upright. We're going to give it to him here on second down and 10. Flag comes out down the sideline across the 35 out at the 37-yard line. In motion goes JoJo Natson. Myers pump fakes that way. He takes off. And he has a big lay down the sideline, 15-10. Jumps for the pylon, touchdown. 48-yard run for the quarterback, Kent Myers, his fifth rushing touchdown. Second and two, but Jones hit in the backfield, and he's tackled for a loss. They're going to mark him back at the 17. He loses two. Jay Maddox punting, left-footed kicker to short end over end. Punt bounces over the head of Natson, grabs it at the 15. Heads upfield, 25, 30, he has a block. Midfield, Natson, 30, 20, inside the 10, brought down at the 5. First down Aggies, that's Natson in motion. Myers throwing, he's going deep across the middle. Some contact, it was intercepted, but there should be a flag. Payne bumped into the receiver.
Boy, maybe the field's right. I guess it doesn't matter now.
We'll take another peek shortly, but there's a sack. That Utah State defense back at the 36.
Defensive back had a right to make the play on the football as well.
That's a loose football, and it looks like UTEP has recovered at the 25. Trying to make it a one-point game. Ball's on the ground, picked up. And UTEP will come up empty. And here's Ronald Butler in at quarterback for Utah State. He's going to run it and takes off. 20, 25, 30. And Butler stumbling, staying on his feet, but is brought down from behind at the 30. Going to cheer on their defense. Won't get the stop. There's the catch. Natson with his speed could be off to the races. Tackled inside the 25 by cornerback Adrian James. Primarily doing it on the ground so far today. In motion, Natson, they fake the jet sweep. Myers keeps inside the 10, 5, and down inside the 5. It'll be first and goal. Vigil in again at back. In motion, Robinson straight ahead and into the end zone. Touchdown. Rushing touchdown for Nick Vigil. Showers to throw on third down and 8. That's intercepted. Myers hit and sacked. Nick Gathright, the cornerback, blitz. Out of the hold of Michael Soroka. It's away and through and good.
Being held accountable academically and on the field.
And a first down run and more. Joe Hill tackled at the 11. And had a Another win perhaps here in the bowl game. And there he goes once again, bouncing into the end zone. Touchdown. Final play of this game, going deep. Showers incomplete. And Utah State has beaten UTEP 21-6 and taken the 2014 Gildan New Mexico Bowl. For Casey Smith, David Diaz Infante, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Mark Neely. Thanks for sharing this one with us. Utah State winners of the 2014 Gildan New Mexico Bowl over the Miners, and so long from Albuquerque.
This is the 2015 Gildan New Mexico Bowl as Bowl Mania is off and running, a beautiful setting here in Albuquerque. And today, the New Mexico Lobos, a home team at University Stadium out of the Mountain West Conference, takes on the Arizona Wildcats out of the Pac-12. Stack the receivers to both sides. This is Baker. No, they throw it out to Phillips, and the ball is loose. New Mexico falls on it. New Mexico ball. Jordan on the keeper, has an alley inside the 30, down to the 25 as the Frisco kid keeps it himself. Gibson and Tyrone Owens in the backfield. And it's Richard McCorley who won't go anywhere. New Mexico looking to get on the board here. Kick is up. And it's good. And this Arizona club going without Nick Wilson, their number one running back for most of the season, has been banged up. He's out with a knee and a foot injury. Here comes more pressure. White with a second chance, and they get to him. Carlos Wiggins back to receive. And it's a fake. And they're not going to get anywhere close. Jordan off the play fake. Looking for six. Has Wiggins open. Intercepted.
But I think that's something he might have to do more today, is keep that football.
Now in single coverage, has his man. Caleb Jones will go. 78 yards. He's going to dance into the end zone. And it's the longest pass play in New Mexico Bowl history. And Jordan thrown down by Reggie Gilbert. He took
all
out two
the
guys.
Time. I never said it.
Oh, interception. Picked off. Cranston Jones. Inside the 25, off the fingertips of the wide receiver, Tony Ellison, and into his hands. Jordan keeps it himself and gets popped on the edge. His long this year is 42. And they fake it to Rodgers, and he gets tripped up. So they went to the fake, and Arizona was ready for it. It was a shovel to the kicker, and he had no chance.
Here comes New Mexico, stacking that line.
Pressure coming. Looking for Jones, and they have him again. Caleb Jones with another big play, got behind Morton. Bottom of your screen to the left. They keep it on the ground, though, to Baker. Gets away from the tackler. Gets inside the 20, still on his feet inside the 15. Gets a block at the 5, touchdown! Now Jordan keeps himself on the option. Gets a block, gets the first down. Still on his feet across the 40, ball comes loose. Looks like it goes out of bounds before Worthy could fall on it for Arizona. Here comes pressure. He steps up, and he will go down. Scooby Wright with the sack. Presley and McCorley in the backfield. Jordan keeps it himself. Gets by Scooby Wright. Still on his feet at the 10. The 5. Touchdown, New Mexico. 31 yards for the quarterback. Pressure coming. Solomon steps up. Still on his feet. Here they come again. Carson can't get to him. And he's wide open. Griffey at the 20. Solomon keeps it himself. Still on his feet. And he takes it in.
Linebacker, as good as he has, got to be able to cut on that foot. Wasn't able to do it.
Now throwing it, looking for the big play. And he got it. Dwayne Hart Johnson. 92 yards if he hurries. One man to beat. Oh, my. The home run for New Mexico. Solomon pumps. Double move. Has his man open. Complete. Caleb Jones again inside the 5.
Caleb has 6 inches on him.
Solomon looking to throw the other way, and he has his man Richards for 6.
The first Arizona coming in. They're a Pac-12 team.
Solomon drops the snap, gets it back, but then gets dropped at the 20. Now Solomon pumps in. He's got his man on the double move. Richards had to go back and get it, or else that could have been an 80-yard touchdown pass. First and 10 from the 32. Here's Baker with a hole, breaks a tackle, and he will score 32 yards. Jordan keeps himself down the line, now tosses it to Presley. Presley gets the first down and more into Arizona territory. Down to the 40. That makes it second and 20 from the 38. Jordan keeping, gets to the outside, still on his feet inside the 20, and then gets out of bounds. So he picks up the first down. McWorley and Presley now in the backfield. Jordan down the line, keeps it himself at the 5. Touchdown, Lamar Jordan. Now they shovel it over to Johnson, who can't get away. So they force the punt. Riggleman thinking about it. Wisely
that makes me nervous. God.
But it takes a great bounce. Can they get there in time?
That's going to be that. That's a great play. That's the rule difference in college football versus pro.
Anaya and Presley in the backfield. Jordan looking to throw. Pressure coming. And it's picked off. Picked off by Alon. And he takes it inside the 5.
Thought had Jordan just hit him deep, he would have been all right.
And Arizona capitalizes as Baker goes right up the middle for his Jordan keeps it himself. Nothing doing, maybe. Looks like he got back to the line of scrimmage.
And again, Scooby Wright.
They're expecting a good crowd and being treated to an entertaining game. They run the reverse. This is Rich Jones. Gets a block, no flags, going to get the first down inside the 10. Third and goal from the 3. Jordan keeps it, lowers the shoulder and gets in.
You wonder if does New Mexico try something on the kickoff here, try to steal possession.
Yes, there it is. And it's live. It's loose. New Mexico ball. They say they have it. Here it comes up the middle. Apodaca out of the pocket. Nobody open. Until White. What's the call? Complete right at the marker. Where are they going to spot it now? Gibson behind Apodaca. Apodaca down the line, keeping it. Keeps it himself and gets in for the score. Presley and Gibson in the backfield. This is the pitch to Gibson behind him. And that ruined the play from the get-go. Devontae Neal with the tackle at the 5. Now Bob Davey more concerned with coming up with a stop on 3rd and 5. Solomon looking for Jones. Incomplete. A great story for Arizona. This team is this year is the kicker, the fifth-year senior out of Phoenix. Looking to make it an 8-point game. No good. This is Presley. Nothing doing. Scooby Wright with a TFL. Ball is loose. Still loose. And it looks like Reese White got it back for New Mexico. Apodaca, though, looking to throw. Here comes Wright on the pressure. Complete for a first down. Damian Gamblin. That was the connection for the game winner against Hawaii. Now they come up with a huge play all the way out to the 40 for 27 yards. 12th play of the drive. They pitch it. Ball is loose. It's still loose. And they fall on it to get set up a 4th down. Apodaca with time for now. Here comes Wright. And guess who? Scooby Wright with the sack. Not here, though. He tacks on the 3. That's it from the 2015 Gildan New Mexico Bowl. Arizona wins it 45-37. For Rocky Boyman and Laura Rutledge, I'm Eamon McEnany wishing you a good night. Arizona holds off New Mexico out of the Pac-12. They finish the season 7-6. They win it 45-37.